This is Land of Havilah, Exodus 18. The last time Moses saw his father-in-law, he was working for him as a shepherd. Now Moses is shepherding over 1 million Israelites. Coming up, sometime during Moses' experience in Egypt, things must have gotten too dangerous for his wife and children there because at some point he sent them back to his father-in-law in Midian. Now as all Israel's traveling in the direction of Midian, in the direction of Jethro, his father-in-law, and in the direction of the mountain of God where Moses saw the burning bush, verse 1. Now Jethro, the priest of Midian, Moses' father-in-law, heard of all that God had done for Moses and for Israel, his people, how that Yahweh had brought Israel out of Egypt. Jethro, Moses' father-in-law, received Zipporah, Moses' wife, after he had sent her away and her two sons. Comment, as Israel was coming out of Egypt toward Midian, Jethro heard the news of everything God did. He heard about the plagues, the crossing of the Red Sea, and so on. This means Moses' wife and two sons were getting the news as well. Verse 3. The name of the one son was Gershom, for Moses said, I have lived as a foreigner in a foreign land. The name of the other was Eliezer, for he said, My father's God was my help and delivered me from Pharaoh's sword. Comment. Hebrew names have meaning. Gershom comes from a root meaning to cast out. Moses was cast out of his native country of Egypt. Eliezer means God is help. Verse 5. Jethro, Moses' father-in-law, came with his sons and his wife to Moses into the wilderness where he was encamped at the mountain of God. Comment, Israel has now arrived at Mount Horeb, the place of the burning bush, the place known as God's mountain, Exodus 3:1. This isn't too far from Jethro's home. Coming up, the message Jethro sent to Moses when he arrived at the camp. Verse 6. He said to Moses, I, your father-in-law Jethro, have come to you with your wife and her two sons with her. Moses went out to meet his father-in-law and bowed and kissed him. Comment, we surmise that when Jethro got to the edge of the camp, he ran into a few Israelites, identified himself, and someone immediately notified Moses. Of course, Moses came out to meet them. Moses respected his father-in-law. He bowed and kissed him. Verse 7. They asked each other of their welfare, and they came into the tent. Comment, Moses has been separated from his family because duty called. It's a common thing. It can be difficult. There can be separation because of duty, death, a breakup, or other reasons, but God is there. It calls for a lot of faith on everybody's part. In Genesis, Abraham, Rebekah, Jacob, and Joseph were all separated from their families. In the case of Jacob and Joseph, it was because of family discord, but God was with them. For whatever reason, separation's a fact sometimes, but God will work the situation through. It hurts him, too. God, quote, daily bears our burdens, Psalm 68:19. In all Israel's afflictions, God was afflicted, Isaiah 63:9. It's God's job to be afflicted and worried over us. Our job is to abandon our affliction and worry and let Him take care of it, 1 Peter 5:7. Coming up, even though Jethro heard all the news, as verse 1 said, of course Moses would be bubbling over to tell the news himself, and Jethro would be hanging on to every word, verse 8. Moses told his father-in-law all that Yahweh had done to Pharaoh and to the Egyptians for Israel's sake, all the hardships that had come on them on the way, and how Yahweh delivered them. Comment, we usually say what's the news, and the answer is not much. Moses couldn't say that. Verse 9. Jethro rejoiced for all the goodness which Yahweh had done to Israel, in that he had delivered them out of the hand of the Egyptians. Jethro said, Blessed be Yahweh who has delivered you out of the hand of the Egyptians, and out of the hand of Pharaoh, and who has delivered the people from under the hand of the Egyptians. Comment, Jethro said, Blessed be Yahweh, and repeated himself about 3 times. Words fail when it comes to adequately thanking God for all He's done. Verse 11. Now I know that Yahweh is greater than all gods because of the thing in which they dealt arrogantly against them. Comment, the Egyptians dealt arrogantly against Israel. Jethro said, Yahweh is greater than all gods. Yahweh showed that He was greater than all of Egypt's satanically backed gods. Verse 12. Jethro, Moses' father-in-law, took a burnt offering and sacrifices for God. Aaron came with all the elders of Israel to eat bread with Moses' father-in-law before God. Comment: Jethro made animal sacrifices to God. Whenever God manifested himself in the Old Testament in some unusual way, often the response of man was to give sacrifice from a heart of appreciation and thanksgiving. That's what we as Christians do. We don't offer service to God to earn anything. We offer service in response to the way God's manifested himself to us. Out of an overflowing heart, we just want to do something. Coming up, Moses is overworked. Verse 13. On the next day, Moses sat to judge the people, and the people stood around Moses from the morning to the evening. When Moses' father-in-law saw all that he did to the people, he said, "What is this thing that you do for the people? Why do you sit alone and all the people stand around you from morning to evening?" Moses said to his father-in-law, "Because the people come to me to inquire of God. When they have a matter, they come to me, and I judge between a man and his neighbor, and I make them know the statutes of God and his laws." Moses' father-in-law said to him, "The thing that you do is not good. You will surely wear away both you and this people that is with you, for the thing is too heavy for you. You're not able to perform it yourself alone." Comment: Jethro's warning Moses about burnout. Indeed, later Moses will get burned out. He said to God, quote, "I am not able to bear all this people alone because it is too heavy for me." Numbers 11:14-15. Jethro goes on, verse 19. "Listen now to my voice. I will give you counsel and God be with you. You represent the people before God and bring the cases to God. You shall teach them the statutes and the laws and shall show them the way in which they must walk and the work that they must do." Comment: Jethro says, "Teach the law." But right now there's hardly any law. If they have law, they'll mostly know what to do and how to judge themselves. Verse 20. "Moreover, you shall provide out of all the people able men which fear God, men of truth, hating unjust gain, and place such over them to be rulers of thousands, rulers of hundreds, rulers of fifties, and rulers of tens." Comment: a judge must be a man of truth and must hate unjust gain, meaning he must hate bribery. Deuteronomy 16:19, quote, "You shall not take a bribe, for a bribe blinds the eyes of the wise," end quote. Verse 22. "Let them judge the people at all times. It shall be that every great matter they shall bring to you, but every small matter they shall judge themselves. So shall it be easier for you, and they shall share the load with you. If you will do this thing, and God commands you so, then you will be able to endure, and all these people also will go to their place in peace." Comment: Jethro says, "If God commands you so." He's not adamant. He's just saying, "Ask God about it." Verse 24. So Moses listened to the voice of his father-in-law and did all that he had said. Moses chose able men out of all Israel and made them heads over the people, rulers of thousands, rulers of hundreds, rulers of fifties, and rulers of tens. They judged the people at all times. They brought the hard cases to Moses, but every small matter they judged themselves. Moses let his father-in-law depart, and he went his way into his own land. Comment: Exodus 19 is next at landofhavilah.net. Exodus 19.